Hello everyone, welcome to iLLPhoCorPhics. Now today we're starting another exciting Adobe Photoshop tutorial. Now today I'm gonna show you how can you darken your eye in Photoshop. And I'm really excited about this tutorial because this is a very good technique and a very good method to darken your eye. And I'm gonna show you all the process step by step and how can you add makeup on your portrait so that it's look more realistic. And this portrait is all about the Halloween and darken. If you upload this on Instagram or social media, it's gonna look awesome. So if you are new, welcome, make sure to subscribe and also press the bell icon because I'm going to come up with more exciting Adobe Photoshop tips, tricks and tutorials for you. And I make Photoshop tutorials for everyone so that they can learn how to use Photoshop. So without any further ado, let's jump chat for the shot. Now we are here, the magical world of Photoshop. Now I'm going to use this image to show you how can you create darken eye. Now to make a darken eye, you need to know some of the process. You also need to darken your lips, you need to add makeup, and you need to add some of the color contrast on this image to make this image more realistic. To do that, first I'm going to darken the eye, darken the lips, then I'm gonna touch the eye, then I'm going to make up all the portrait so that it look more realistic. Now first to make a lips, darken lips, you can use brush tool, blank layer, then painter, but you know I really love to work non-destructively, so that's why I'm going to use adjustment layer that I can adjust in later. And so that is a very good, and I really always prefer you to try to make all the things in non-destructive way so that you can adjust your color or contrast in anytime. Now to take this one, just first go to adjustment layer, take solid color. Now just take solid, it's a fully solid color, don't worry, just take the black point because we're working black colors, so that's why just hit OK. Now we're targeting the lips, isn't it? Now press Ctrl or Command I, just select this layer mask, don't this one, select the layer mask, then press Ctrl or Command I, it will invert or remove all the color from the image. Now we're going to apply the color in the particular area, in this case the particular color is our lips. Now take the brush and increase the flow and opacity 100%, make sure the brush hardness is 0% and size as you want, you can adjust the size on later. Now just OK. Now we're going to apply our color into the lips, just go closer and make the brush a little bit smaller. Now first to say something, if you want to paint on your lips, I am going to paint two separate layer. I have a previous tutorials on how can you apply colors on your lips in that description, and I also find that on I button, you can check it out how to make colorful lips. You can, I hope that you like it. Now just first do that, I'm going to apply the color, I'm going to apply the color on the side, then I'm going to mill it, and I'm going to use two different images to do that. Now first go to this one and do the same thing as I do. Now we just done our down lip, now we're going to do the same thing on the upper lips. Now go to adjustment layer, do the same thing, just go adjustment layer, take solid color, then take again the black color and take the mask, press Ctrl or Command I, invert it, and do the same thing, apply the color in all over the lips. Now we just apply the color into the lips. Now we need to change the blend mode into multiply, do the same thing on both layer, change the multiply and second one and also the multiply. Now we just see, but you can see it's not showing any kind of details over here. Now we need to bring back the details of the leaves. To do that, just double click on here. It will come up the layer style, the blending option. You can also find it, just go to FX icon, then blending option. Now come to this underline the blend. If you want to make the highlights and the details back, you just need to press alter option and then click drag it here. And I have a previous tutorials, more tutorials, you can check it out in my channel, and also in the link description you will understand how to use blend if. Now you can see it's bringing back the details over here. Now in this case I'm happy. Now okay, do the same thing on the upper lips. Just double click on here and press alter option, then break it down and bring it over here. Now it's okay. Now hit okay. Now we just apply our color into the lips, and we're working on the adjustment layer or non-destructively, so that you can adjust it anytime and anywhere as you like to. And I don't want to spend a whole bunch of time to refine this one, and because I want to show you quickly how can you do that. Now this time come to our the eye. First I'd like to make it a group. In this case press shift, then select this one, press Ctrl or Command G to group it. Now name this group it into lips, lips, and this case is okay. Now change, now take another adjustment layer for the eye. To do that, just go to adjustment layer, then solid color, and take it over here and change, select the layer mask, press Ctrl or Command I, invert it. Now take the brush, and we're going to apply the same adjustment layer on the both eye. Now do the same thing, just take time and add your color. You don't need to be perfectly, and I think you'll have to apply the color all over the eye. And this case this is okay. Make this brush is a little bit smaller, then click and drag. Okay, now this is great. Do the same thing on this eye. Now it is done. Did you done it? Isn't it looking great or kind of fake? And we need to do more adjustment to make it more realistic. Now in this case I would like to change the blend mode into multiply again, and you can use any kind of blend mode, but in this case I would like to apply this one. And what about changing this one? Just try to do that. What is the perfect way? In this case overlay, I think overlay is not perfect. What about hard this one, linear dot or something, and this coins. Now change the blend mode is into the multiply. It's okay. Now decrease the opacity a little bit, just not too much, and this is okay. Now you can see it's bringing back some of the details in this image. Now we're done. Can see we just apply our color into the subject, but in this time we need to bring back the highlights of the middle point of this, because you can see there's some of this is light falling into the eye, and if you don't bring back it, it's not going to look realistic. To bring back it, just invisible it. Now go to this channel, and then in this case we need to bring back the highlight of this, yeah, the blue colors of this light. So just press Ctrl or Command and then click it here. It will select this light. Now go back to this layer. Now take a blank layer, and it's okay. Now take the brush and apply the color. In this case I would like to decrease the flow a little bit, around 80, something like that is okay. Now make the brushes a little bit bigger, then apply the color, and in this case is okay. And do the same thing on this one, and this is great. And just bringing back. Now if you think it's too much, don't worry, you can adjust it on later, but this case is okay. Now bring back the blacks, then press Ctrl or Command D to deselect all this one. Now you can see you just bring back the details. But if you think this is too much, don't worry, just down a little bit and you can adjust it in later. Now you can see we just add our light into the image so that it's look more realistic. In this case I'd like to add more, and how about that. And I think it's too much on this area, don't worry, we can decrease this one. Just take the eraser tools in this case, and opacity flow, and just remove those area, and What about the flow? Anything hardness is too much, and to decrease the hardness, then remove this areas a little bit more than, and try to fix it over here. Now we just turn it, and if you want to think it is too much on here, you can also remove this one. It's not a big deal, but it's, you know, what is the process to do that. Now press Ctrl Command D, then see what is happening. Now it's looking great. Now this is done, and we need to adjust more adjustment layer to make this eye more realistic. Now to do that, in this case, make the opacity 100%, and then go to the adjustment layer and take our curves. Now decrease the curves value around this one, and this is perfect. Now it's okay. Now invert this one again. Press Ctrl Command I, then take the brush, and now apply this one, because we don't apply the color on this area, so that's why we're going to apply the adjustment black on that area and the side of this one to make this more realistic. Now apply this one, and just in this case it's perfect, and do the same thing on this area too, this one, and make this one invisible and hit okay. Now this is great. Just with this, now you can adjust it as you want. If you like to don't like too much, you can add it, and if you'd like onto too much, you can adjust. It depends on you how much you like to add black on your eye. Now this is great. Now the second the last thing we need to adjust all over the color, and we need to add some of the makeup on the face so that it's look more realistic. Now to do that, first I'm going to apply some of the color on the side so that it's look more realistic. Now in this case, go to adjustment layer again. Now take the curves. Now decrease the value of here around like that, and increase this highlights a little bit. Don't worry, just don't need to decrease this one. Now change the this one again. This time we don't want to change this one. We're going to use brush, make the brushes a little bit bigger, and remove this one. Remove this from here, the face, and a little bit, just okay in this case, and also this leaf too, and okay, this is great. Now this is great, it's been done pretty much. And the next thing we need to do, we need to apply this apply the layer adjustment. To do that, just go to its image and apply image. Now if you think it's highlighted this area, just invert this one. Now it will darken this area. Now hit okay. Now we are done. The next thing we're going to do, we're going to touch our model face. So do that, just this time go to adjustment layer, take the brightness, bring down the brightness, increase the contrast, and it's okay. Now to go again, adjustment layer, then curves, and increase this one a little bit more than this one. Now balance the color with brightness and contrast layer and the curves layers. Now do that again and make this one more dramatic looks around this one. How about that? And it's okay. Now group these two into one, press shift, then press Ctrl or Command G to this one, the B and C, like this as you want, and I think B, E and C for me, and it's okay. Now we need to apply some of the makeup color on the face so that it look more realistic in this case. To do that, just go to adjustment layer, then take again the curves, bring that down a little bit, just okay. Now invert this one again and press Ctrl or Command I. Now take the brush, and in this case I'm going to apply all the color on the some of this area. In this case, you can see, so is this area is darkened. If you add more darken this one, this area, it will look more realistic. Now make the brushes a little bit bigger, then a little bit okay. Now apply this one, just change the foreground color is white, then apply like this one, and this one is great. Do the same thing on this eye too, then bring down the flow a little bit more, then apply this one, is this area, also the eye, and also this area to this, and it's okay. Now do the same thing on this some of this area. Now we're just makeuping our models so that it looks more realistic. In this case, I think I'm happy with this one. And how about that? Okay, and do the same thing a little bit this area. Now this thing is perfect. Now we can see we just done it, and I think it's okay. And now if you want more adjustment, more makeup, you can add that, but in this case I'm happy with my portrait, and I make a darken in my image so easily and so perfectly. Now it's a very easy one to do that, but not an easy one. It's, you need to some of the process. How can you do that? Just make sure your image is good enough to darken the eye, and I hope that's gonna help you. Now see the before one and the after one. This is the before one and this is the after one. We just apply our eye darken into the portrait. So I hope that you like it. You like it, smash that like button. If you don't like it, you can kick that on the dislike button. It depends on you, but I like to like, just I just want to give a like to my tutorials and share with your friends in other social media so that I can grow up with my channel. And if you like it, you can also make sure to subscribe, because I'm new and I really need your support to grow up. So friends, support me to grow up. So that's for today, and I hope you will stay tuned till the end. So see you in the next tutorial. Till then, bye. And the most important thing, guys, I always say to you, keep learning.